Hello students, so we have started with literature, new stepping stone, literature reader 6. This time we have started with the poem Coromandel Fishes. I have told you about the title of the poem, that what does it refer, and also about the poetess Sarojini Naidu. She is the poetess of the poem. I have told you about other famous poems which are written by Sarojini Naidu, and I have also told you that she is an Indian writer, and that's why in his poems she has depicted a lot of Indian characters, Indian situations, Indian traditions. So you would also feel a little connected with the poems, and they are related with us. Or whenever you will go through them, you could easily connect with them, because you would be able to recognize the Indian situations, Indian traditions. So now let us start the Coromandel Fishes. Coromandel Fishes. This poem is basically based on the life of fishermen, those who go for fishing. Okay, though. And this Coromandel, as I have told you, it refers to the fishermen on the Coromandel coast south of India. So it is referring those fishermen who are going for fishing. So this is, it is written here, read the early morning song that rises from the hearts of the simple fishing community on the west coast of the Bay of Bengal. So it has been made clear that she has written this poem keeping in mind about the west coast of the Bay of Bengal, where the fishers are going for fishing. Now let us start with the first stanza. Rise, brother, rise, the wakening skies pray to the morning light. The wind lies asleep in the arms of the dawn, like a child that has cried all night. Come, let us gather our nets from the shore and set our catamarans free. Class, this poem is full of, you can say, poetic devices or figures of speech. As and when they will come, I'll tell you about those. There are, as you can see, the very first line, it begins, rise, brother, rise, wakening skies. Here also you will find that use of simile is being done here. I'll explain. So I think simile you have done earlier also. Simile and metaphor and personification separately in my next video, I'll explain all those things. First here you have to just understand that they are being used. Here one of the fishermen is calling other fishermen. He is calling them and saying that rise, get up. This is not the time to sleep. This is time to get up, because the wakening skies. The sky has also woken up. How? Means at night it seems as if it was also sleeping. It was also quiet. Now it has woken up. So the wakening skies, the sky which has woken up. Pray to the morning light. It is also praying. The wind lies asleep in the arms of the dawn, like the child that has cried all night. And he is saying that this is the time for us to get up, because this time the wind has also become quiet. Students, if you have ever been to a seashore, you might have noticed that during night time, what happens, the tides, high tides, we could see high tides during night. Okay, that becomes because the tides, they rise in the night because of the moon's gravitational pull. So due to moon's gravitational pull, you can see there is a rise in the tides. You can see high tides, and sea becomes some say that the sea becomes horrible during night. Okay, because the tides are very high. But in the morning time, once again it becomes quiet, and during night time we feel a lot of wind also, which is blowing from there. But in the morning time, everything has become quiet. This is what he is saying, that this is morning time, and the wind, because the wind was blowing throughout the night with the tides. So now, it according to the poet, The wind has tired up and it is sleeping just like a child. As a child sleeps in the arms, sleeps in the arms of the dawn. Dawn means morning time. So the wind is sleeping in the arms of the dawn just like a child who has cried all night and now he is sleeping. Because what happens when a child cries a lot? He feels tired. And when he feels tired, then he sleeps quietly for hours. So this is what here also the wind has been, because due to the high tides, the wind also it was blowing throughout the night. So according to the poet is comparing wind with a child who has cried all night. And now he is saying that it has become very calm and it is sleeping. Sleeping means it has become calm in the arms of the dawn. In the arms of the dawn, morning. So as soon as the morning came, the wind became quiet and it slept. Slept means it became calm and quiet. So here you can, as I have written simile, S-I-M-I-L-E, this is one of the figure of speech or poetic devices which is used in the first stanza. Now rest of the poem we'll explain in next stanza.